In this video, I'm going to show you something really interesting and I'm sure you're gonna like it. In this training, I'm going to teach you a strategy that you can use to write better prompts for your AI image generators to get the result that you want, either if you want to create a new image or if you want to edit an existing image. You can use this strategy to get a better prompt, and by that, through that, you get a better result. So if you're ready, let's begin. This strategy that we are going to learn today, it's very simple and straightforward. All you need to do is to just think a little outside the box. So let's get started. Here we are inside Photoshop. You can use this strategy on any tool or any AI model to generate images or edit images. But in this video, in this example, we are going to use this plugin inside Photoshop. This is a plugin that I made it myself, and it will give you access to 4 AI models like Seedream, Nano, Banana, Quinn, and Flux here. You can write your prompts, adjust the settings. And also we have more AI models like Clarity Upscale or Topaz Upscale or some fast actions, which we don't need to talk about them in this video. This is for the Pro version, and in the Core version, we have these AI models here. Again, I'm repeating this, you can use this strategy in any other AI image generator tool that let you write a prompt, okay? So most of the time, when you want to edit an image or want to make some changes or create an image, we get to this problem of writing a great prompt. Sometimes we don't know the exact words we need to use. Sometimes we don't know how to communicate with the AI model to get the result that we want. In this strategy, you can fix this problem. So what I do is that what I come on Claude, you can use ChatGPT, you can use Gemini or any other AI models like this, and you can explain what you want. For example, I mentioned, let me make it bigger. I mentioned I have my portrait image in dark background. I want to write a prompt for AI image generator to edit my photo. Inside the parentheses, keep my position and posture exactly the same. Then to change the background and add the studio lighting like backlight or side lights with colors, I want something professional like a portrait image for magazine. Now I want you to write several prompts for the AI image generator so it gives me the result that I want. So by explaining like this, these kind of AI models like Claude or ChatGPT can write the prompt that works much better for you, and from there you can pass it to AI model and get a better result. So here is the first prompt it wrote for me. I'm just going to copy it. For this first prompt, I'm going to show you how it is. For the rest of the prompts, I have prepared the result earlier, and we can just quickly take a look at it. And one thing, most of these results are good, but I'm sure you're going to love the final one. This last one is my favorite, and I'm sure you're going to like it a lot. And I think by the end of this video, you will be interested in this to try these strategies on your own images. So let's try that. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to just make a selection. I'm going to make a selection and I'm going to paste my prompt here. And I'm going to select Seedream 4. You can select other AI models, but usually in these kind of things, in these kind of styles, Seedream give us a better result comparing to Nano Banana or Flux or Quinn. For example, Flux is terrible at this kind of stuff. So just to show you what would be the result, I'm going to turn all of them on at the same time so you can see the result. And we have our image, our prompt is set, and I'm going to just click on generate. Now the good thing about this plugin is that it works in parallel mode, so you can generate all images at the same time, so you don't need to wait for each image to complete, then go to the next one. So some of our images are ready. And this ugly one that you see is made by Flux. All right, everything is ready. Only Nano Banana is okay. Nano Banana failed for the first time, and it's going for the second time. Sometimes these AI models, it happens. Sometimes they face some issues and they fail. All you need to do is to just retry again. Usually Nano Banana works much faster, and usually it completes before the other ones, but now it took a little bit longer. So let's look at the result. This is the result by Nano Banana. You can look at the layers on the right side. This is a Nano Banana result, which if you want to compare it to the original one, it's not very much different. Only on the left side we have some light on the face. Then we have Seedream version, which moved me a little. Sometimes it moves, sometimes it, most of the times if you tell the if you mention this in the prompt, it will keep your position and posture. And here is a Flux version, which didn't move me a lot, but the result is it's not good. And here is from Quinn. And Quinn is more or less the result looks good, right? It's a little bit plastic style, but more or less it's cool. So let's look at the results and samples that I have created using these prompts. So this was the first prompt. Here we have about six prompts. And here I have tested them all. So this was the first version, right? It's simple. This was the prompt that we used. So sometimes the prompt is okay, but the AI model doesn't understand it clearly. When you try it one or two or three times, then it will give you a better result. So this is the second prompt. This is the third prompt, which is like studio lighting and the background. It's really good. White background, right? This one, for example, this one is really good. The lighting on the face, just look at on the left and the right side if you compare it to the original one. You see? It's really good. You can use this, for example, for profile picture or some professional photos somewhere that you need. And this is the last one. In the last one, it changed my posture a little, but still, the result is really good. Now, this was an example of describing what you want. You can also show what you want. So, what do I mean by that? If you come here, you can provide images to AI models and say, hey, I want an image like this with my photo. Just write the prompt for me. So, I went on Google and searched for portrait photo shoot and I found this image. I found it interesting. The lighting was good. And I uploaded the image here, just copy pasted here, and I wrote down, I found this image and I want a background and lighting like this, but with my own position and posture. So it generated again six prompts, and here were the results. Let's look at the result together. So this was the result. We have better lightings as let's compare it with this image. It's not 100% blue like this, but it is getting there, right? Now you have to try different prompts to see which one matches your style more. I tried with other images as well. Let me show you. Here, I wanted to make it more complex. I want to get a better background as well. So I get this photo, which is in the street. Even though that the main character here is a woman, it worked perfectly as well. It created several prompts for me. And here are the results. So we have the street with the street lighting in the background. This one, the lighting, the left lighting, and look at the hair. It's really good. It created, these are the good things that you can find only on Seedream. Some other AI models can't get a good result like this. This is also another example, which is really good. So I tested different styles and images as well. For example, here I tried black and white image, and here I tried business image, and let's look at the result of both of them. So this is the black and white version. Now, in some of them, it moved my posture and position. In this one, it kept it and just made it black and white. which is good. And let's look at the result of business style. So let me just take a look. So here is the prompt that I wrote for Claude. I want a business photo with my face, but you can change the posture, clothes, background lighting, and more. Here's a sample, and I pasted this. Let's look at this sample as well. It's a simple sample. I found it again on Google. And here's the result. Now, this image is bad because of my smile. I don't like it at all. But I kept it so you see that some of the results that you may get could be bad. But if you keep repeating the same prompt or maybe just make some changes in the prompt, you can get a better result. So these were the next prompts. And as you can see, for example, this one is really good. This is also bad again because of my smile. It's so unreal. And this one was really good. And this is also really good. So you get the idea. You can provide more information to AI models like Claude or ChatGPT and get a better prompt. Now let's look at the next example that we have here. Oh, this one is really interesting. So this is the image. I wanted to go crazier. I wanted to try something new. This is what I'm telling you. Think outside the box. So you are allowed to change anything, but keep my face. For example, you can change the glasses, position, posture, colors, and so on. It gave me 6 prompts, same as before. And let's look at these prompts together. So this was the first one. And I really like these particles, and just look at the result on my shirt, on my hand, part of my hand, and my face. It really looks good. I can use this on a poster, right? This one, we have some golden material in the background. It looks cool. And this one, we have some smoky color in the background. So you see, you can play with this and get better results. Again, I tried to push it. I tried to test different styles. I found this image and I wanted to see if it can understand. Now, the result was not bad. Sometimes it tried to change my position and posture, which I didn't like it. But for example, in this one, it changed the style. It's so-so, right? Maybe we can use it. So we can also use images with specific kind of a style, like cartoon style or animation style, and get a better prompt and just paste it for AI here. Now, this is the last example, which I really like, and I'm sure you're gonna love this one too. So again, I went on Google and I found this image. I think it was here. Yeah, I found this image. And as you can see, it has tags on it. Here as a prompt, I mentioned, now try this one. Also change my clothes to dark black suit and stylish sunglasses. So it's a combination. I provided the image and I also added some text that, right, I want this as well. And here were the examples. And let's look at the result we got here. So this was the first one, which the lighting, it's really interesting. We have the black suit, we have sunglasses, although I don't like the sunglasses. This one, this is also really good. Now, sometimes Seedream show the light source. All you need to do in the comment, in the prompt, just mention, don't show the light source, just show the light effect, and it will remove it. And this one is also really good. Oh, this one is cool. For example, you can use this in many different cases. This one is also fine, and I like the sunglasses here. It looks really good. And the best of them was this one, I think. It looks really good. Actually, it's the same prompt. First, I got this one, and I said, okay, I should try again. And then it gave me this one, which it looks really great. So this is what I'm telling you. You can try the same prompt with these AI models several times, and each time you will get different result. Now I'm gonna show you. Let me come here. It's this one. The last prompt is this one. I'm just gonna copy it. Okay. And I'm gonna come here. Let me just turn this one off so we have our original image. I'm gonna select it. I'm gonna change the prompt. And I want to show you the different results done by different AI models. And also here, if you pay attention, we have a number. It's on 1 by default. You can put it up to number 4, and it will use this AI model 4 times with the same prompt. So now if I click on this, it will generate 7 images at the same time. So our time will be saved. We get 7 results, and then we can choose, okay, I like number 2, I like number 4, I like number 5, right? You can choose from them. And it's really, really good. So this is, yeah, since it's ugly, it should be Flux. Now, Flux is a really good AI model, but in these kind of styles, it doesn't work really well. So here are Seedream results. As you can see, the same prompt is giving us a lot of options, a lot of different results. So this was the Flux one, which it's not usable. This is from Quinn. This is also good, right? It looks cool. It's not very high resolution, but it's cool. This is from Nano Banana. The hand doesn't look so good. This one is from Seedream. Again, this one is also really good. Yeah, that looks really good. This one, wow. I like this one as well. It's like I'm somewhere strange. Anyway, generally this is how you can get a better prompt for AI models and make changes on your images or on the projects that you're working on. And don't think that this is just for portrait. You can get this on anything. Let's say, hey, I want to create an ad image for, let's say, a juice can, right? So I want you to write a prompt that create a good advertisement image for this can, which provide more information. It's orange juice, for example. I don't know, you select the environment, what fruits could be around it, what weather, what kind of light should be around there. So you can use this strategy in any cases, right? In any scenario. Now, if you are interested in these kind of videos and you want me to create more of these videos, share more strategies with you, don't forget to like and leave a comment. I can understand that you are interested and you want me to create more of these videos by liking and subscribe and by liking and leaving comments. This way I can understand that you were interested, right? And if you are not subscribed yet, don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos, which here we are doing our best to publish one video every day, sharing new strategies, talking about new AI models and a little self-development. Look, my goal here in this channel is to share information that can help you grow with AI, right? Grow your income, improve your business, your career, become a better person, better version of yourself, and get to your goals and be more successful. This is my goal here, and I do my best to deliver that on my videos. So I hope you like this training, and I hope to see you soon on the next one.